Welcome to another GT Online Racetrack review, and this time we're going to take a look at ZennyCudo Park Plus, mapped by Zenvo. You got the map of the layout, so yeah, this is another ZennyCudo racetrack, and I gotta say this one has quite a long history to it. So back when it was initially made, I think it was a land race, so from one of the videos I could find about it. And it kinda shows, since it's more of a basic layout, it doesn't have that many track extensions, some elevated parts, but you could also have that as a land race with all the elevated parts, just a slight difference. Yeah, but yeah, so it's more of an updated version of an old track instead of an original new one. Also, this has been rebuilt multiple times back when it got changed from the land race into a sand race, and back when there also was a different layout to it in one of the parts. Basically, instead of having this part here, you would end up going over here, and over here also this chicane wasn't there back then, but yeah, that has been changed again. I think there has been at least one big update since it was built into a stunt race, and it kind of looks completely different than what I was used to, so let's have a look at it right now. I'm also going to show you the old layout, since it's still possible to take that route, although it's not popped in any way anymore, but just to show the basics of it. So let's get going. We got the pit lane on the left here. Normally you would just take the hairpin, go around this, most likely close to this prop, and take this a bit wider for the chicane, which didn't, as I said, used to be here for the other layout. And then come to this section. I gotta say, this track really has quite a nice flow to it, and this is where it would deviate from the current layout. So of course it was elevated a bit over there, so you wouldn't have to drive on the grass patch. And this is where it would get back on the normal track. Of course you could take it a bit differently. Right now it doesn't really have the space anymore. It's been blocked off a bit because the corner goes differently now. So back to the normal route. And I gotta say, I like them both quite a lot. I think the other one is a bit more original, although there used to be a few problems with the chicane. Some people crashed there quite a lot. And this thing has a bit more of a flow to it again, because with the small extension over there, it kind of makes them both corners feel more as one, and that improves things quite a bit in my opinion. So quite a nice way to do that. And yeah, that's a bit of a problem with that part. I'm going to talk about that in the second lap. Also, we've got quite a few warmer strips here and there, which isn't nice. So first of all, this gap here, as on some of the other tracks, I don't think at this point is too much of an issue. Although you end with a left turn and you get into a left turn, so people are going to be on the right anyways, and if you find another prop to spare to just block this off, it wouldn't be any bad. It would maybe have some of the issues, although as it is right now, it's not any bad anyway, so yeah. Just mentioning it. I mean, on this part it has been done. I think this is a bit more necessary since it's right at the end of a corner, and since it's lowered into the ground so much, you can go on this part. So I think it would be quite devastating. And looking at it, it may still be a bit of an issue, so maybe put up that prop a bit higher, because you can still kinda ram into this thing. So yeah, I'd just put this up a bit higher, because it can still cause a few issues. Other than that, I really like the use of a prop here of the starting grid. Quite nice with the fence over here. This gives a bit of a bump, which I think is quite okay. If you are going too wide out here, your car gets upset a bit, and yeah, that's definitely okay by me. So for the pit lane, I generally like the idea of going around the hangar. This gives it quite a nice feel. But the thing is the re-entry. You kinda have to go very close to this prop. And that's exactly where the normal racing line is, so people could get into each other, especially since the people from the racing line are taking another approach on this and likely taking this at more like this angle, and the other people coming out of a pit are somewhere more like this, and therefore likely to go out wider after this corner, and therefore kinda crossing the racing line. So in an event this could cause a few crashes. I don't think people are using the pit lanes outside of events anyway, so yeah, but in an event it would be a bit of a shame to have this happen. So I'm gonna give you a suggestion on how where to maybe relocate the pit lane later on. Although I gotta say, I looked around this track and it's quite hard to find a really good spot. There's always either not enough space really or something else in the way, so yeah, that's it. I gotta say, I really like this chicane as this here. It's quite well made with the props below here to just stop the bump boost from happening if you really go very close to this edge. And well, if you try to cut it too deep, you get on the other prop, which kinda well upsets the car. I actually managed to fly over on this part after the second bump during the testing, so yeah, wasn't too much of a problem since I could just drive on this without a problem and jump back on the track at a later point. Also, I like the use of inside props here. Some people are going to say that these aren't too good from the hitbox either. I think they are way better than the guardrails, but the thing is, yeah, these also have a few issues here and there with the hitboxes. Can't really escape that. A lot of the new props aren't too well made, but this is one of the better ones, and I think these work quite well here. So for this thing, I don't think this is too good to have this as an inside prop here, although I know these are world props and not actually placed by a creator. But the thing is, they have 90 degree corners. I think you should just find a prop to put over it. I would like to try one of the tubes. Well, one that is three segments long but open at one side, so one quarter of it is cut out. You could just have the side that's open over here, so it wouldn't actually go on this side of the track, but then the other part would be somewhere around here, and yeah, hopefully not make this too narrow, but at least cover up this thing without getting in the way here. So I would try this one. Otherwise, there are still the diesel tank in the machinery tab that could help, and that's also in general quite a nice prop. I wish we would have those things as a prop. They are everywhere in the world and they would make such good inside corners for a lot of things, but yeah. The diesel tank is basically the smaller version of it and works quite well as an inside prop because it really has a smooth surface and a good hitbox. So for this thing, I really like some of the rumble strips that are placed around the track, but the thing is, I think most of them could be extended a bit. So if you just took the 30 player starting grid and put it down into the ground so that only the rumble strip is visible, like it has been done here. Only with the basically the longest pop possible. Then I think it would be a bit better. I don't see too much of a reason to have it start at this point and end over there already. It could just go over the entire length of this straight. I don't think people would get too many bump boosts out of it anyway, so I mean it's a bit too smooth to get to really get a big bump boost. It's more like a wiggle boost at that point. And for this outside wall here, I think it would be nice to if this was extended at least to this point, so that it would end somewhere over here and the people couldn't get into these things, because well, the racing line is right next to it. If you want the optimal angle to go into the next corner, you will want to be as close to the outside as possible. So I think it would be nice to just extend this and close this here. This isn't part of the race anyway anymore. And for this one, I'm not too much of a fan of this pop in general. I think it's kind of outdated. It still looks nice, but when it actually comes to racing and the inside pops, I think this should only be used in some circumstances. And I think for this part, one of the diesel tanks again would be a better pop at this point, because having something slightly circular is better than having something that's just straight with an edge at the end. Again, this could be extended, I think. Having a bit of a longer one, I don't think it makes much of a difference, so this is the one that I think it's not really worth bothering too much with, but quite nice that it's here in the first place. I would like to see this being covered up, since when you are going around this corner, you kinda want to align yourself with the next corner already. So racing line is kinda S-shaped at this point. So you're going over here and then getting back over here, and if you go too close to that thing with the poles around it, you are kinda getting completely screwed over. So I would cover this up. Maybe with one of the stunt targets, so that would be going kinda around here and something like this. That would be the one singular pop that could nicely do the job. The bigger the radius of a pop, the better, because when if you have a really small pop, it would be sticking out like this or something. With a pop that has a larger radius, you are not running into that problem. And I think for this corner, this is actually a good inside pop, although I'd like to see it switched around so that the red is on the close to the edge. That would improve the contrast a bit, although I think it's not really necessary at this point. It's quite good as it is right now. It's covering up the... I think this is a double edge basically, and that's covering it up quite well, so yeah, nice use of that pop here. This rumble strip again could be extended in both directions, just make it as long as possible and kinda just vanish into the greenery over there. I see too much of a problem with that. Also gotta say that these things can cause a few problems, because they are really unsmooth. And yeah, it kinda shows when you're just going too close to them, so there's not always too much that can be done about it. You could cover it up. I don't think it's entirely necessary, but just keep in mind that those aren't really smooth pops, and yeah, that's basically that about that stuff. I like this thing here to just to give a bit more contrast, that this is this is a corner here, and that you don't want to run into the brick wall over here. I think just to have it a bit more consistent, I would just use one of the containers that you already use on some of the other corners over there, just to give it a consistent look, because you use that prop multiple times. I don't think this is a wall prop, but I'm not entirely sure. So this track extension, as I think I already mentioned, is quite a nice one. It connects both corners over there and over here to give it a bit more flow, and really like this extension for that because it kind of improves the track a bit, and that's something you don't see on every one, on every track that has this corner, so quite a nice job here. For this one, however, I think it would just be better to have another diesel tank or something like that. I'm not too much of a fan of this popping, although I gotta say this is still a better way to do it than just having a 90 degree barrier or anything like that. Having it kinda in parallel to the racing line is not the worst way you could do it. So yeah, if you are still using some of the old concrete barriers, this is basically the way to do it right. But I think there are still some better pops out there. And this one strip again could be just extended as long as possible. Also, there's a bit of a special thing with this. If you could manage to align the top edge of the rumble strip over here to the edge of a ledge here, then it would just be so smooth that you don't even need to try to get people away from it. So you could just delete this prop, have this rumble strip being as long as possible and covering up this thing. I mean, people would likely wouldn't go on the dirt anyways because it doesn't really help with the racing. I would make it a lot smoother, make it look really nice, and let's improve the entire thing just that tiny bit. And yeah, there is maybe one problem with that. If you try to align it properly, you may run into creating a bump over here. To avoid that, you could just use one of the, I think there's those are elevated parts, or I don't know how it's actually called, but use one of the 30 player starting grids over there and put the entire prop kinda in the in this thing here, so that only the rumble strip is visible here. I think that may it might just cover up this thing with pavement again, but that would also likely look very good, and I think that would it would be a nice idea to do that. By using the elevated part, you would avoid some parts of the prop sticking through the road, which may otherwise be a problem. So again, the inside here, I think this is definitely a part where you could use one of the 3 segments long cut off pipes again. That was the word I was looking for. So just use one of those, so that the open part is over here and it doesn't make this anymore narrow as when it needs to be. I think it shouldn't go over this part, however, and that would just improve it a little bit. You could also have it like going around this a bit more, so it's basically the radius of it would be like something like this, to not have it go too much onto this track. I don't know the exact diameter right now, so I'm just assuming things. Yeah, my suggestion would just be to try this pop on this part and see how it fits the best. So really like this thing over here. Quite a nice little extension that also keeps people from just going on the dirt too far. I think you could just use one prop to try to build a wall here so people can't knock over the lamppost here. Same goes for the other side, but well, I think in some of the playlist races this may be an issue, but not one of the bigger ones, so as it is right now, it's not really a problem, but it still could be improved a bit. This is one of the smaller suggestions, but I think when you got a few people side by side, there's always stuff that can happen. So, and now for this. This, I think, is the one pop that really needs improvement, so I think this should be just rotated so that the front part is behind the other stuff. Or even better, extend it so that this covers these gray things. I don't know what they are called. But just have us cover them and go over there to to somewhere over there where nobody's going anyway. So just block off the entire site here with a white one prop and maybe use another prop for this radius, maybe one of the stun targets again to block off those things, because they are really not any smooth. If you get into this, you're kinda getting bumped into, even though it doesn't look like you could be. And this may also be an issue that I mentioned with the LS Marine GP, that the hitbox of a car is shrinking down, going through maybe one of the props but not through the other, as you have seen here right now. So yeah, that's something to keep in mind and something to improve here. And maybe for this part also a target, a stun target or something like that, because I don't think it's too good to have a 90 degree barrier here. Basically covering up this pole is a good thing to do, but I think it could be improved by having a circular prop to help funnel people into this stuff, because if they run into it, they're basically done for. And now to the suggestion where the pit lane could go as an alternative. Have a pit entrance here so that people would just go a bit deeper around the corner. And have them go around here. And we enter back on the track at this point. Maybe you could also move this a bit forward so that this is a bit out of the way. Pretty sure that's the other prop over there. But in general, I think for the track re-entrance it would be way better, since when you are going through this corner, you end up on the outside. And also I should mention that I'd like to see this here, this one, with the race standard like some of the other ones. So if you are looking at the racing line here right now, you are basically going to take it a bit wider, so people who would be rejoining the track on the inside would have enough space. And could just get back on the racing line during the straight here. So yeah, that's basically all I gotta say about this track. Overall, it's a really nice one already. Most of those things I just mentioned are basically some suggestions. Nothing really of a type that it would be way better to do. It's a lot of the things are just try and see if it improves things. So yeah, that's basically it for this track. Thank you for watching, I hope it was helpful, and see you next time. Bye bye.